Science Lab. It was a science lecture. All the children were paying attention.
Students, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen combine to make water. This is the chemical formula of water.
But sir, how does it come to know? Where can you test the drop of water?
This can be done in the science lab, kids.
Can we see hydrogen with naked eyes?
No, they are too small to be seen with just eyes. You need a specific instrument for it. Let's do one thing. Coming Friday, we will visit the science lab. I will answer all your questions then and there.
Okay, sir.
Then it was Friday.
Students, we are going to the science lab. Keep one thing in mind. Do not touch anything in the lab. Just watch and observe. You will get the information about all the equipment. Stay in a line and maintain the decorum.
Okay, sir.
Soon, all the children reached the science lab in a queue. Everyone was amazed after entering the lab. There were tall instruments on the tables. The teacher showed them the microscope and said,
"This is a microscope. It is called sukshmadarshi in Hindi. Our eyes can see things to a certain capacity. Things that are not visible to the eyes can be seen through it. It was invented by Antony Leeuwenhoek. It is used in zoology and botany to see up to a cell. Its capacity can be increased by the lens."
Wow! This is amazing, sir. Can I see a cell in it?
Yes, why not? One by one, all of you take a look at these things. You can even see the germs present in a drop of the water.
After that, all the kids were observing the microscope.
If you are done watching the microscope, then let's go ahead. Let us see how the chemicals are made. Let's go.
Yes, sir.
Come, let me show you some special instruments first. This round tube is called a test tube, and its stand is called a test tube stand. It is held in a holder, so you don't get burnt while heating it. All of you have to see.
All the children hold the test tube in their hands.
Now look at this. It's a measurement. It has different capacities, from 10 ml to 500 ml.
But why is it needed, sir?
So that we can take the right amount of chemical. All the formulas that are made here need to be recorded even up to a millimeter. It helps in creating a chemical formula. Do you remember the formula of water that I told you?
Yes, sir. H2O.
Very good. All of you remember it. Now look at this. A wire mesh. When these jars are heated, there is a possibility of breaking the glass due to very high flame. It is used so that the flames don't touch the glass directly.
Does it control the heat, sir?
Yes, kids. Try to remember. When your mother or grandmother keeps the pan on the gas, it gets directly heated. But if the glass utensil is not of good company or quality, then it breaks. However, all the equipment in the chemistry lab is made of good quality glass.
Okay, sir.
Now look at this. This is a tripod stand. It has three legs. Hence, it is called a tripod. A net is placed on the top of it and a lamp is lit below. Wait, let me show you how.
Teacher explains how to set up the tripod stand. All the kids also tried to set it up. Then Bunty said,
"What are those colorful tubes, sir?"
"Those are not colorful tubes. It is the color of the chemicals in them. Actually, they can also be called different types of glass utensils or equipment like burette, pipette. You don't have to remember all these names. You just have to understand how things work in a science lab."
Okay, sir.
Students from the 9th class above do practicals here. You will also get to do it when you grow up.
Sir, to become a scientist, do we have to work in such labs?
Yes, kids, in the lab. Becoming a scientist is a long process. You are too young for that now.
Then the lab assistants entered.
Hello, sir.
Hello. Students, he is our lab assistant. He takes care of all these instruments and also keeps a close eye on the children in here to check if they are using the right chemical. Now he will tell you about some instruments.
Hello, sir.
Hello, kids. Come, let me show you the fuel tube. It is very small. And let me show you the platform balance.
The vegetable sellers also have this.
You are absolutely right. This is the same. They have some big measurements. Here we have the digital instruments even for very small measurements.
Sir, are those bottles full of colors?
The assistant starts laughing and says,
No kids, they are different types of chemicals which are kept in the glass bottles.
Why is everything kept only in a glass bottle, sir?
Some chemicals are inflammable, which means they can burn. Plastic or other bottles may burn. That is why most of the chemicals are kept in glass.
Wow! But it can be kept in steel or iron bottles too?
Some materials react with iron as well. That is why it is not kept in it.
The teacher was watching them from a distance. He is very happy to see their curiosity.
I am very happy, kids, that you observed and understood everything so carefully. I think now you have got enough information. Now say thank you to the assistant, sir, so that we can return to our class.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, kids.
And like this, all the kids make a line and return to their classes.
If you are liking our videos, then like them, comment them, and subscribe.